got a basic set, the fundamentals of design, right? That part of it was meant to be a teacher's module so that very quickly these simple things you can go teach. And why do we believe that you can go teach? Not because we spoke to you, but you experienced it, right? You experienced it, and on the next time you teach, it's going to be, you're going to fumble a little bit and so on, but I guarantee you, with the slides we are going to set you up with, and the experience of having done it, by the third time you do it, you'll be smooth as silk, okay? So it'll go just fine, and we'll be there to help you, right? The second part was not a teach the teachers thing at all. It was actually, you guys got exposed to a small segment of our absolutely latest processes, and you didn't get very much of an explanation of why we're doing what we're doing. You just got thrown into the end of the pool and says, swim, right? And you know, we were looking at the reviews from yesterday. You know, we got some really fantastic comments from you. A lot of 4s out of 5s with saying that, you rushed us too much, right? And of course, our egos are a little hurt because elsewhere we get 5s out of 5s. So we are saying, wow, we did, you know, we have to, you know, put on even a better game. But at some level, I'm not apologetic about how hard I pushed you. Two reasons, fundamental reasons. You think differently when you're under, but you're going to use different parts of your brain that you're not going to use if I give you 2 hours. And the other thing is, innovation is a fast-paced contact sport, right? I'm going to use the words of Michael Andretti, who's the racing car driver, famous racing car driver. If you're in control, you're driving too slow, right? Don't expect to be in control. Don't expect the comfort of complete understanding by the time you have to act. Action comes first, understanding follows, right? That's the game, right? Because you have a chance to reiterate. You're always reiterating. The understanding that comes with the action, with the fogginess and the lack of control, you learn from, and then you come again and do it better. If you stop to have complete comfort, A, you take 10 times the amount of time, not 1.3 times, 10 times, and B, your solution would not be better. You'd still have the failure modes in there, right? So today we are going to share. Why is this not moving? And then generate many innovative solutions, brainstorming, and strategies and systems and paradigms. You remember what paradigms are, remember Foster Flop, right? That's what a paradigm is. It's not just a solution, it's something that's very different, is rewriting the rule books. And it doesn't neatly fit in a mechanical engineering or economics or anything. It's at the crossroads of many domains, right? You have to, it crosses through sociological issues, human issues, technology issues, business issues, the whole 9 yards, right? And to remind you, this is an emerging form of leadership because the game is one of creating new capacities and new creative approaches and new value systems and new options. That's the game. It's not about controlling everything. It's not about optimizing resources. Optimizing resources is a different game. It's about exploring what you can do with the same resources. Right? It's not just stemming losses. It's multiplying what you have by 1,000. That's a different game, right?